Adobe Fresco is a new painting and sketching app for tablets that aims to lure artists and illustrators away from their workstations. I got early access to the new Creative Cloud app on iOS, which Adobe plans to officially launch later this year, and one thing is obvious. This app might be as big a game changer for the iPad as it is for Adobe. The iPad started life as an oversized iPhone, but with the introduction of the Apple Pencil and professional-grade design and photo editing apps, the iPad has evolved into a powerful tool for creators, and Adobe Fresco represents another huge leap in that direction. While it's not the first drawing or painting app for the iPad, Fresco is unique because it seamlessly integrates with Adobe's desktop tools like Photoshop and Illustrator by supporting both pixel and vector-based brushes in the same document. Projects created in Adobe's desktop apps can also be opened and edited in Fresco, and then exported back without any file conversions needed. Compared to other drawing apps that have been available for iOS for years, the pre-release version of Adobe Fresco I tested was light on features and customizability. But thanks to Adobe's Creative Cloud service, it does provide access to thousands of different brush designs. Adobe Fresco also introduces an innovative new feature called Live Brushes that mimic the experience of working with actual paints. Brush strokes and colors flow, mix, and interact with previous strokes the same way they would on a physical canvas. However, the most interesting thing about Adobe Fresco is that it gives us a sneak peek at how fully featured versions of Adobe's flagship apps will work when they eventually come to the iPad and other tablets. Photoshop and Illustrator users will find Fresco's interface familiar, with tools that can be repositioned on screen, a layer stack that can be reordered, and even access to complex masking tools. Adobe Fresco also takes advantage of the iPad's hardware in useful ways. You can use multi-touch gestures to quickly undo your last brush stroke, or double tap the Apple Pencil to quickly change paint colors. I've been using apps like Photoshop for over 20 years now, and adapting my old methods to the iPad's touchscreen took some effort. The early version of Adobe Fresco I tested didn't support keyboard shortcuts yet, which can be a crucial part of an artist's workflow. But being able to hold, reposition, and even spin the iPad around while drawing is a big improvement over an immovable desktop screen. What's most exciting about Adobe Fresco is that it's a glimpse into the future of what creatives can do with an iPad and tablet devices. Adobe expects to release a full version of Photoshop for the iPad this fall, as well as Fresco, and that means I might be able to ditch my desktop setup completely and do all of my creative work on the go. It's taken a while, but with these new tools, the iPad might finally set us free.